If we go back 25 years ago, we used to have one single forecast issued every day. Problem we had was that we didn't know whether the forecast was going to be accurate or not.
When we take observations of the atmosphere, you know, it's like when you have a thermometer in a room, and if you put another thermometer next to it, you will not necessarily have the same reading because nothing is perfect, which means there's always uncertainty in what we measure and what we predict.
Ed Lorenz was one of the first to really cast it in a mathematical framework with which he was able to demonstrate that you make a tiny error at the initial time. That tiny error is going to grow into a very substantial error.
We always say that atmospheric weather prediction is an initial value problem. So we first determine what is the state of the atmosphere now, what is the initial value, the initial conditions, and then we run a model. Traditionally, people were just using one model typically in one center. They were just doing an analysis of the atmosphere, using one model, and then getting the forecast for the next few days. And that was very much what we were doing. We were taking the best image of the atmosphere with the observations, the best model we could get, and we had one shot in the future to say what the forecast is. Ensemble prediction is about running one model several times. And in particular here at ECMWF, we were trying to change the initial conditions of the forecast.
For each point over the globe, instead of having just one value of temperature, we have 50 value of temperature at initial point. The same for wind, the same for pressure.
And this would actually trigger the atmosphere to go in different directions in our forecast.
Then I can estimate using all of them what's going to be the possible range of forecast. And this was, for example, extremely helpful in the summer 2003 when Europe experienced extreme hot temperatures. So with our ensemble system, we're able to predict these extremes 2-3 weeks ahead.
What we really use a lot is tropical cyclones and the trajectory of tropical cyclones. So there, you look at it on a map, not on a given point, but you really look at the different trajectories of the tropical cyclones.
You probably have heard of Hurricane or Superstorm Sandy along the east coast of the United States. And that was a case where the ECMWF prediction system provided a heads up a day or two in advance of our own U.S. Weather Service prediction systems. And that was a success story.
So I think at the beginning, we were trying to really push the forecast where it was going to be sensitive. Then we started also to incorporate some idea on the uncertainty in the observations, sort of quantifying actually what comes from the uncertainty in the observations themselves. And finally, the third step has been to actually quantify what is the uncertainty in the model itself. We know there are some ranges where some parameters could lie, for instance. And so it's quantifying these as well.
So now, if I think about the future, we want to make our models better. We know, for example, that the coupling the models to the ocean is key, and we have started doing that. We want to improve the initialization of the model to our estimation of the state of the atmosphere. Third big area of work is resolution. So we need more resolution in the system.
We have a very high collaboration goal that we really think we benefit if we collaborate with other organizations.
Oh, my colleagues and I really think the world of ECMWF. The scientists are really defining the forefront of the operational ensemble predictions and where the research needs to head to address the remaining deficiencies in ensemble prediction systems.
Yeah, it's fantastic, extremely motivating to know that you're working in a place where you can really make a difference. And whenever we have a good success in our forecast and we think we might have saved lives using the science to do that, I can't think of anything better to do.